The controversy is going to be emblazoned, and the president is maligning his critics. Let me ask you this. When this deal was signed, all sanctions were off, yes? Or all sanctions will be phased out over a period of time. Which is it? The Iranians say all of them are off. Now, John Kerry and the president say, oh, no, we're supposed to be phased in. Well, if you can't agree on that, how can you agree on anything else? Then the question is, how do you inspect them? And who inspects them? And how deep can the inspection go? And can you have snap inspections? Or do you have to notify and give the Iranians a month or two to clear things up before you go in and look? It's a bad deal. It could not only threaten Israel, but the Middle East. That's the entire world. That's the latest warning from Benjamin Netanyahu, the Prime Minister of Israel.
And it comes as the battle over President Obama's nuclear deal is really just heating up, with everyone from Congress to Capitol Hill pushing back against the plan. Heather Sells brings us the story.
The president says the framework for the potential deal allows unprecedented inspections of Iran's nuclear facilities, cuts its supply of nuclear fuel, and limits its ability to produce highly enriched uranium. It also gives Iran relief from crippling economic sanctions. But how those sanctions would end is an important issue. The sanctions have hurt Iran's economy, and Iran wants them lifted immediately. But the U.S. and its allies are pushing for a slow process that could take months and even years.
And despite the president's promises last week, the White House now admits that several key sticking points remain before any definite agreement can be reached. And now Congress is asking for a final say on any deal.
It's very important that Congress is in the middle of this, understanding, teasing out, asking those important questions.
Corker has the support of a key Democrat. Politico reports that Senator Chuck Schumer, likely the next leader of the Democrats in the Senate, strongly endorses the passage of a bill that would allow Congress to consider and possibly reject any agreement with Iran. Other Democrats support it too, as do Republicans, but the White House is pushing back.
It's the responsibility of the President of the United States, any President of the United States, to conduct the foreign policy of the United States of America. That there is a concerted effort in Congress to undermine the negotiations or undermine the successful implementation of the agreement.
Israel, meanwhile, is voicing major concerns about the proposed deal. Right now, it does not force Iran to stop threatening Israel, nor does it require Iran to even recognize Israel's existence.
Endangers the region, endangers the world, endangers everyone listening to me right now.
Even the day after the president announced the tentative deal, leaders in Tehran led prayers chanting death to Israel and death to America. Just another point that critics are raising, as key questions still remain about any deal over Iran's potentially deadly nuclear program. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Truth is, the Israelis are going to have to get in there and blow up some of those facilities. If they don't do it, they're putting their whole nation at risk. So it's just a question of time. The president thinks he's got a deal. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. And he's being laughed at. And the fact that they're chanting death to America, when they're supposed to be our partners in peace, what a nonsense. What utter nonsense. They are the instigators of terror around the world. And now, that situation in Yemen is coming apart. I mean, it is terror. The Saudis are bombing. Other Sunni countries are bombing. The Iranians are undoubtedly sending troops and supplies to help the Houthi rebels in Yemen. That's going to be a Shia-Sunni war that's going on down there. It's going to threaten the oil supply like crazy. There's the Dab al-Mandeb waterway that goes into the Red Sea. That's one choke point. The other is the Straits of Hormuz. Iran can choke them both off, and we're talking about skyrocketing oil prices. The whole thing is in a chaotic situation, and our president is thinking, oh, they're wonderful partners in peace.